This lecture is about the definition and difference between absolute, fractional, and percent uncertainty. Absolute uncertainty is uncertainty expressed as a number independent of the original number. The symbol we use for absolute uncertainty is the symbol delta, and then the letter variable for what we're measuring. Fractional uncertainty is uncertainty expressed as a fraction of the original number, is delta, and then the variable over the original variable. I'll explain why that is in a moment. And percent uncertainty is uncertainty expressed as a percentage of the original number. And you can see I have that symbol and equation written there. I'll give you a visual to understand the difference between each of these. Let's say that we have 4 plus or minus 1. What this would look like on the number line is we have the number 4, but the actual value of this measurement could be as high as 4 minus 1 or 4 plus 1. So the red line indicates the value of the measurement, and the blue line indicates the value of the uncertainty. I can understand how big that uncertainty is without referring to the 4. I can understand that no matter how big the red number is, the uncertainty itself is going to be plus or minus 1. It'll go up 1 and down 1. So because that number is independent of the measurement number, that uncertainty is expressed as an absolute uncertainty. I'm going to write the same number and uncertainty, but with fractional uncertainty. I need to understand what fraction the uncertainty is of the number. And I can see here that 1/4 of my number is uncertain. 1/4 of my total measurement I'm uncertain about. It's not that full range from 3 to 5, it's not 2/4. It's half of the range, because that's how we usually express uncertainty, is half of the full range. So 1/4 of my measurement is uncertain. So that fraction expressed as a decimal is 0.25. So 0.25 times my measurement is uncertain. So this is how I would express that uncertainty with fractional uncertainty. This is the uncertainty expressed as a fraction of my original number. And percent uncertainty is uncertainty expressed as a percentage of the original number. And if 1/4 of my measurement is uncertain, that means 25% of my measurement is uncertain. You can see that these expressions all express the same uncertainty. They're all referring to that same red and blue line. They're just different ways of writing that same uncertainty. So absolute, fractional, and percent uncertainty are three different ways of recording the same fundamental thing. And you can see now why the equations work in the way that they do. Because the fractional uncertainty is the absolute uncertainty, delta A, divided by the original number A. In my case, it was 1/4. And the percent uncertainty is that fractional uncertainty multiplied by 100%. 25% is 0.25 times 100%. These equations will always work to convert from one uncertainty to another. In comparison to absolute uncertainty, we call fractional and percent uncertainty relative uncertainty, because the value of the uncertainty is relative to the value of the measurement. So with absolute uncertainty, even if I don't know what the measurement is, I can still understand the exact size of the uncertainty. Here it's just plus or minus 1. That's absolute on its own, so I can understand it independently of any other number. But for fractional and percent uncertainty, if I can't see the original measurement, I don't actually know how large that is. So if I'm dealing with 25% of 1, that's going to be a very different size of uncertainty compared to 25% of 100. So the actual physical size of the uncertainty is relative to the original measurement in a way that it's not with absolute uncertainty. So we say that fractional and percent uncertainties are both examples of relative uncertainty for that reason. These are instructions for converting between each type of uncertainty. When you're going from absolute to fractional, you divide the absolute uncertainty by the number. When you're going from fractional to percent uncertainty, you multiply the fractional uncertainty by 100%. And in the other direction, if we're going from percent to fractional uncertainty, you divide by 100%. And from fractional to absolute uncertainty means you multiply the fraction by the number. The unit of measurement is written in a different place for absolute, fractional, and percent uncertainty. For absolute uncertainty, it's written to the far right of the number, because both of those numbers are measurements in that unit. They're both independent of each other and absolute, so they're both measuring amounts of that unit. Whereas with fractional and percent uncertainty, we put the unit only next to the measurement value, not next to the uncertainty, because that uncertainty is not actually measured in the same units as the original number. It's some fraction or percentage of that original number, so we're not using the same units for it. as an example, if we were measuring something in kilograms, this is how we would write the absolute fractional and percent uncertainty with the unit in the correct place. And just looking at the bottom right, it wouldn't really make sense to say, oh, this is plus or minus 25% kilograms. Like, that statement on its own doesn't really make sense. So we say instead that it's 4 kilograms plus or minus 25% of that value. The placement of the unit can tell us whether the uncertainty is absolute or fractional. You can definitely have decimal uncertainties that are absolute. So a way of understanding whether those uncertainties are absolute or fractional is to look at where the unit is in the measurement. If it's an absolute uncertainty, the unit occurs after the number and uncertainty, but if it's a fractional uncertainty, the unit is only written after the number, not after the uncertainty. There are rules for decimal places in absolute uncertainty, but not really rules for fractional and percent uncertainty. If the absolute uncertainty goes to more decimal places than the number, the uncertainty is rounded to the same number of decimal places as that number. And if the number goes to more decimal places than the absolute uncertainty, the number is rounded to the same number of decimal places as the uncertainty. So the lowest decimal place of both the number and the uncertainty always have to match. And you always round up the value that goes to the lowest decimal place. There are no clear rules for recording significant figures or decimal places in fractional and percent uncertainty. The amount of significant figures you record will usually be told to you in the problem. And if you're not told about them, it's okay to write the number of sig figs that you would like, because the problem isn't being clear enough on its own. The rest of the video will just be example problems where I convert between different types of uncertainty, using the rules that I introduced earlier. I'm going to start by converting each absolute uncertainty to fractional uncertainty. So to do that, I divide each absolute uncertainty by its original number and rewrite it as a decimal. And I can now rewrite these values with fractional uncertainty. So the numbers stay the same, the unit is moved next to the number, and I'm now writing in the fractional instead of the absolute uncertainties. Going to the right, to convert each fractional uncertainty to absolute uncertainty, I multiply the fraction by the original number. And when I do that, I get the absolute uncertainty for each number. And you'll notice that I rounded the uncertainties correctly to go to the same decimal place as the original numbers. And as a policy, we usually round absolute uncertainty to just one sig fig. So the number of places in the uncertainty must match the number of decimal places in the original number. Going down and to the left, I can convert each fractional uncertainty to percent uncertainty. This is one of the easiest ones. You just have to multiply the fractional uncertainty by 100%. So this is how you would write those fractional uncertainties as percent uncertainties. And then I can convert each percent uncertainty to fractional uncertainty by just dividing by 100%. That's the rule for conversion there. I can now take two steps and convert each absolute uncertainty to percent uncertainty. So to do that, I'll convert from absolute to fractional and then from fractional to percent. So I divide the absolute uncertainty by the original number and then multiply by 100%. And this is what I get for those values. And again, I move the unit to the correct spot in each number. Finally, I'll convert each percent uncertainty to absolute uncertainty. So to do that, I can divide by 100% and then multiply by the original number. And when I do that, these are the absolute uncertainties that I get. And notice again that I'm not changing the actual value of the uncertainty, I'm just writing it in different ways in each problem. So in each problem, those answers are the same values as the others. It's just that I'm changing how I express them between absolute, fractional, and percent uncertainties, but the underlying value of each number is the same. I'll close with some rounding problems where I just round each number to the correct decimal place, and then round each uncertainty to the correct decimal place. So all I need to do is round each number to the same decimal place as its uncertainty. When I do that, this is what I get for each number. And on the right, because the uncertainties go to lower decimal places than the original numbers, I have to round those up to the lowest decimal point of each number. And when I do that, this is what I get for each uncertainty. So that's what you have to know about the definition of absolute, fractional, and percent uncertainty and how to convert between them.